Hello, mortals. I am the booktube goddess, the number one drag queen booktuber on YouTube. And I was tagged by CJ Reeds. If you don't know her, please check her out. She is great. But she tagged me with the bar and the bookcase tag. And the original tag was by the bar and the bookcase booktuber, who is adorable. You've got to check him out if you haven't already.
First question is an old-fashioned historical fiction recommendation.
Oh, how about Burr by Gore Vidal? If you know the story of Hamilton, Burr is about Aaron Burr and gives a much different historical analysis of what the founding fathers could have been like. Very entertaining, highly recommend.
Except Sidecar, book with a strong supporting character.
How about Samwise Gamgee from Lord of the Rings? He's kind of the ultimate sidekick character. And I adore Sam.
Question, a Manhattan, a book set in New York. First of all, I feel like what book isn't set in New York City?
Excuse me. How about The City We Became by N.K. Jemisin? This is a departure from her previous novels, as it's a contemporary with a Lovecraftian twist. And in this story, there are some cities in the world that awaken and that an avatar appears. And when New York awakens, the avatar is a young, homeless, black, gay man, as he's representative of the city. And then he does battles with a mysterious enemy, this otherworldly enemy, and it doesn't go well, and he is wounded. And that causes New York City to fracture, and new avatars arise in each borough. So for instance, in Manhattan, there is Manny, who is some kind of mobster or something. And then in Brooklyn, there is a person named Brooklyn who is a former rapper. And then there is Bronca in the Bronx, who is an older queer art director. And these avatar, and so on for each borough. And these avatars have to get together to find and save the avatar of New York. And there is one avatar, Island of Staten Island, who is not going along with the rest of the group. So it's the first book in a series, and I'm really excited for it to continue.
Bloody Mary! I do love a Bloody Mary. I would even drink a virgin Bloody Mary. It's like, yeah, tomato juice and pickles and weird stuff in it. Come on. Book that scared you slash messed you up.
I think you know what I'm going to say. The Wasp Factory by Ian Banks. Ian Banks is a science fiction author who I liked a lot. And I read The Wasp Factory, which is a horror novel that he wrote before he started his science fiction career. It is a story of Frank, who is a 16-year-old psychopath who has already killed 3 children when he was a child, and that's not a spoiler because it happened in the past before the book opens, and he has this weird father that plays mind games with him. And then he has a brother named Eric, but Eric is locked up in a mental institution when the story opens, and the main complication is Eric escapes the mental institution and they think he's heading back home to open up whatever can of worms that opens up. And it's a lot. This book is a lot, and it is the creepiest book I've ever read. And it has some disturbing moments to it. And if there's a trigger warning that you can think of, it probably should apply.
Espresso Martini, book that kept you reading into the night.
Well, the last book that did that for me is Gideon the Ninth by Tamsin Muir. That book hooked me right away, and it was just one of those books where I couldn't stop reading. And it's a curious book because it's about necromancer and necromancy, but it's set in the far future in space. So it's, if you've ever seen Van Diesel's The Chronicles of Riddick, that is the exact same aesthetic that Gideon the Ninth has.
They are a plague that now sweeps through the worlds of man, leaving behind a trail of dead planets and towering icons, monuments to their unholy crusade.
All those poets on all those worlds who spoke of war as such an unsightly thing, they never stood here.
Never fails to inspire, does it? Each time a world falls.
The Necromongers, a dark army that will convert or kill every last human life, unless they can be stopped. But sometimes, the only way to stop evil is not with good. You must confront it with another kind of evil.
And Gideon the Ninth, the main character, is this kick-ass lesbian warrior who is partnered with a necromancer to go on these trials on another planet. And the voice of the narration is third person. I think it probably should have been first person, but it's third person. And the voice is just, it's Gideon's voice. It's sarcastic, it's salty, it's funny. I just could not put this book down.
Sazerac? Sazerac? I don't know how to say that, but the prompt is a book that left you disoriented.
I'm just going to say Dahlgren by Samuel Delaney, and I know I say this book in a lot of my tag videos, but it's one of those rare books that have stuck with me, and I know a lot of people don't like it, and I don't actually recommend it because it's very difficult to read, and it's considered science fiction's Ulysses, like Joyce's Ulysses. It's that odd, and it explores what I think is timelessness. It takes place in the city of Bologna, where some mysterious apocalypse has happened, and everything is sort of in this fugue state. There's no real plot. There's a lot of graphic sex, and a lot of disjointed scenes. It's very psychedelic, and it follows the story of the kid. And he's just existing and surviving through this city. And like I said, I don't actually recommend you pick it up. But if you have read it, let me know in the comments what you thought, because I know it can be a little polarizing.
Long Island Iced Tea, book that is doing too much.
Well, I thought Lore by Alexandra Bracken did too much. She did too much world building, and I didn't think it worked. But, I think for one that did work, let's go with Game of Thrones by George R.R. Martin. Because he has a lot of stuff going on there. A lot of relationships, a lot of characters, a lot of geography. There's just a lot. And in my opinion, it all works.
Negroni, a book with a triangle. I do like a Negroni, only because I feel like I'm supposed to like a Negroni. Like, it's supposed to be like a chic sitting on a patio summer drink.
I thought Negroni had champagne in it. Or let's ask the bar and the booktender.
If you don't know what a Negroni is, it is one part gin, one part sweet vermouth, It is one part gin, one part Campari, one part sweet vermouth. Triangle. My mind. Brilliant, right?
Well, I'm going to say the Dave of Ad Trilogy by S.A. Chakraborty. Do I have to explain it? Okay, well, if you've been living under a rock, the trilogy includes City of Brass, Kingdom of Copper, and Empire of Gold. And it is about a woman named Nari, who is a half djinn, and she has these healing powers. Well, the love triangle involves a traditional genie named Dara, who is ancient and powerful and brooding. And then there is Prince Ali.
Prince Ali, handsome as hell, above all. That physique, how can I speak? Wicked the name.
Now, Ali, or Prince Ali's aide, is an extremely devout Muslim, as are all the characters in this book, which makes it quite a departure from the Western books we're used to. And while usually I'm not all that fond of triangles, this one does it very well, and there's, you know, hate to love, there's complications, and there's resolutions.
Bay Breeze, book with a light, chill, heartwarming vibe. I feel like Bay Breeze is like a flavor of Boone's Farm. I'm probably wrong. Also probably dating myself. Do you think teenagers now drink Boone's Farm?
I'm going to say Forget Me Not by Ellie Terry. It is a middle grade book in verse that is just so heartwarming. It is about Calliopeia, who has Tourette's, and they move around a lot because of her mother. But when they do settle down in this one neighborhood, she develops this relationship and friendship with her neighbor. And it's in verse, and it is very moving, and it is heartwarming. So give it a try.
Dark and Stormy. I've never had one of those either. Book that's dark, thrilling, and menacing.
I'm just gonna say Stormlight Archive by Brandon Sanderson. It's all of those things and more. Whether you like it or not, I think Stormlight Archive is going to be a classic fantasy series that's going to be up there with Lord of the Rings, Wheel of Time, etc.
Last but not least, okay? Martini, classics recommendation. Absolutely cannot stand a martini. Actually vile to me, tastes like rubbing alcohol. God bless everyone who can handle that drink.
Well, I'm going to go back a long ways. I'm going to go back to 1749 and recommend Tom Jones by Henry Fielding. Now, if you think Emily Dickinson and Charles Dickens is the mother and father of the modern novel, Henry Fielding is the grandfather. And it could be argued that Tom Jones is the first writing in the modern novel format. And that may make you think that it's a very dry, boring book, but it's actually pretty racy. Yes, Tom Jones is a bastard foundling, and he is lusty and lascivious, and he goes on his adventures through the bourgeois. It was made into a movie with Albert Finney that's quite good as well.
We are all of us as God made us, and many of us much worse. Tom Jones was much, much, much worse. The whole world loves Tom Jones.
So if you're looking for a classic novel, why don't you go way back and read the original, and I think you'll find it's more racy and raucous than you might expect. So cheers, Tom Jones. What? Oh, I have to tag some people. Well, let's go ahead and tag Break Even Books. How about Star Reads YA? She is so fun to tag. And Sarah, Voyage Through Worlds. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And until we meet again, may all the books you read be blessed.